Welcome to Social Elo Ministries, where we are committed to glorifying God while exposing the devil. I grew up in Jamaica, and one of the things about the island is you can stand on a bridge, let's say 20 feet above a river, and look down into the river and see the very bottom. You can even see fish swimming in the waters. But there are times, for example, after heavy rains, where there's flooding, the water is full of sediment, and your vision is not as clear. But after a while, it'll clear up again. When I moved to the United States, the first time I went to a river, actually maybe the only time, I went tubing, and I noticed that the river was brown. And when I looked into the water while floating on a tube, I couldn't even see to the bottom. There were times when I went under the water and actually it kind of felt disgusting. And when I was under the water, I could barely see in front of me. And I'm not sure if the river is always like that. And I know that there are rivers here in the United States that are similar to those in Jamaica where, for the most part, you can see to the very bottom. But the message is, there are some people who have an occluded vision of the Lord. Like when I mentioned in Jamaica, when it rains and the water becomes cloudy, there are times when people see the Lord like that, as if he's always angry. They never get to see his goodness, never get to see his love. They kind of see anger. And there are people who preach an angry God. He's always angry, always angry. But that is not God. In a lot of cases, those people are preaching that constantly angry God. They're actually seeing Satan masquerading as an angel of light. And many people are operating under deception. Does the Lord always have a reason to be angry? Yes, the world is full of sin. But is the Lord always angry with you? No. If you feel as if the Lord is always angry with you, there's a problem. Especially if you're not someone who's living in sin. For example, if you're in an adulterous relationship, the Lord's going to have issues with you. But even then, he's patient to want you to come to repentance. I mentioned about the river in Jamaica where there are times when it's cloudy. You can't even swim in it because there's debris. The rapids are much stronger. But even then, it's a cleansing, but then it clears up. God's anger, it's redemptive in nature. For example, when the Lord told Jonah to go to Nineveh and preach against the city, they repented, and the Lord relented of his decision to destroy the city within 40 days. So God's anger is redemptive. It is not meant to condemn you. I want to mention about their river quality. In Jamaica, some people actually go to the river to take a bath. But even if they don't necessarily go to take a bath, just by swimming in the waters, when they come out of the waters, they feel clean. But the river I mentioned that I went in that was full of brown sediment, I came out of those waters knowing I needed a shower. Stark difference. And that's one of those things to look out for. When a person preaches the gospel to you, does it make you feel clean or does it make you feel dirty? And there's a difference. If you're living in dirt, it's going to cause some issues. And here's the difference between conviction and condemnation. The Holy Spirit convicts us of our sins, again, leading us to repentance, back to the Lord. But I just want to share this last thing with you, or at least I think it is, and it's relating to the rivers of water. In John 7, starting verse 37, in the last day, that great day of the feast, Jesus stood and cried, saying, "If any man thirst, let him come unto me and drink. He that believeth on me, as the scripture saith," or Christian, "had the scripture hath said, out of his belly shall flow rivers of living water. But this he spake of the Spirit, which they that believe on him should receive. For the Holy Ghost," or the Holy Spirit, "was not yet given, because that Jesus was not yet glorified. But Jesus spoke about, out of his belly shall flow rivers of living water." When you're receiving the gospel, whether it's convicting you of sin or not, does it feel like rivers of living water? Or does it feel like you're drinking from a cesspool? The gospel is meant to cleanse us, consistently cleansing us. If you're drinking waters from a source that is making you feel dirtier, that's an issue. So in a sense, are you swimming in the sediment-filled water, like what I experienced in the Shenandoah Valley? Or are you, for example, rafting on the Martha Bray River in Jamaica, meandering, looking over, and seeing all the way to the bottom? God bless you.